Меня зовут Виктория, являюсь корреспондентом авиатранспортного обозрения. Сегодня мы берем интервью у Таноса Паскалиса, генерального директора авиакомпании Elenair. So, nice to meet you, Thanos.
Nice to be here.
So, first question, I would like to understand the situation about the Elenair in general. So, could you clarify the information about the strategy of the company?
Let me give you a bit of background. We are about 6 years old, so we're a fairly young company. We basically started with a fleet of two Avro RJ aircraft and moved up to the A320 series fleet. We fly about 1 million passengers a year, and we basically fly between Greece and the East, and we do a bit of domestic network as well. So our aim is to bring Russian tourists down to Greece in various locations, not just Thessaloniki, which is our base. We also fly to Heraklion, Rhodes, Corfu, and a number of other airports as well. And we hope to be able to increase the number of passengers we fly from Greece up as well to bring more Greek tourists into Russia. Our basic aim is to serve the Muzanidis Group Travel, who is our parent company. It's a group that's been in tourism for more than 25 years and a major entity both in Greece and in Russia.
And are you planning the diversification? I mean, or you only can survive near the Muzanidis?
At the moment, we would be about 95% inclusive tour. So the Muzanidis group gives us the majority of our customers. Now we have a small schedule network. We are looking about opportunities to increase that with a number of alliances like we've recently signed with Vnukovo Airport, which is very important to us. But it's still under evaluation and it will take a bit of time because what we do, we want to do right. At the moment, the Muzanidis Travel Group is our major customer. We fly most of their customers. And we will continue to do so.
Mm-hmm. But like I understand, you are interested in the situation of working by yourself, not only with the Muzanidis. So how much time you can expect you need to start to do it?
Well, we did do it in the past. So we did have a small scheduled network, which we've actually changed. We've cut down and we're looking to increase it in a different way. We're also looking at destinations for scheduled network within Russia. Like we looked at St. Petersburg to flying there all year round, which at the moment there is no other operator. So we're looking at a number of different things. But mainly Muzanidis Travel for 2020. For 2021, there's a lot of different options that we could follow. And that's under evaluation within the next 6-7 months.
And for now, do you have a long strategy or a short one? Can you just make numbers maybe about the passenger traffic that you're waiting this year and also next year and maybe nearest 5 years?
I think you have to look at our fleet strategy to start with. So what we used to do in the past, we basically had a small fleet of dry leased aircraft. And we doubled the fleet in the summer by bringing wet lease ACMI capacity in. This will be the first year that we've changed the strategy because of a number of problems we had with wet lease operators. So we actually are not buying in capacity, we're actually increasing our own capacity.
How much aircraft you for now have by yourself and also the wet leasing?
It will be 6 aircraft which we have ourselves and they're all in the A320 group. So we're expecting the 5th and the 6th to come in December this year and then April 2020 we'll have one additional A320 coming in. So we're changing how we fly, so we're taking control of all our flights basically internally. And the number of passengers, at least for 2020, is not expected to change dramatically. So we're around that 1 million mark, more or less. No major change. We hope that we were able to get more Russian tourists down to Greece. We believe there's an opportunity there. And we did see an increase about 10 to 15% 2019. But we are hoping that 2020 will be better.
And if we are talking about the Russian tourists or so, what is the volume of Russian tourists for now you have? What is a percent? How much percent of all flights you do?
Well, if you look at it in 2019, we would be about 75% on the travel group and 25% schedule. 2020 will be 95% on the IT part and only 5% schedule. So most of them will be inclusive to customers flying down to various locations in Greece with Elliner, which is our own product.
And if we are talking about the relationships with Vnukovo Airport, so there was an information that you have supporting from the Vnukovo Airport. What is this supporting?
This is a two-way street. I think, as you've seen from my presentation, it's very important that we have good partners to cooperate with. An airport is very important. We have the right elements between Vnukovo Airport and Elliner. Both parties have agreed to a number of actions that will increase traffic on both sides, both from Russia and Moscow to Greece and vice versa. And we're actually defining these elements as we speak. So the cooperation is two level. Level one, we've agreed that we will cooperate on marketing, on routes, on aircraft and positioned in Vnukovo. And the second bit will be how we actually develop that. But it's a good start, and I think we need more of that.
If we're talking about the Vnukovo, I have read that there will be participation in connection with the aircraft. So they will support you by the aircraft. I didn't catch this moment.
Well, not exactly. Elliner is a Greek company, and obviously we have our own fleet. But the support can come in many different ways. And how we operate aircraft into Vnukovo, the number that we have based there, the number of flights that we actually perform at Moscow Airport in Vnukovo, and a number of other also marketing activities which we can do together. I think we've seen that it's an airport that suits us. It's an airport that's very forward-looking, and we are also in a changing mode on that front. And I think the relationship ties in, I'd say the word fantastically, at the moment.
Okay. And can you clarify a bit more, if it's possible, about the relationships with Vnukovo? How much aircraft you would like to base here?
Well, this year that passed, the summer that passed, we had one aircraft based. Now we're looking at a possible two aircraft based in Vnukovo. But either way, it's all about scheduling the right flights in and out. So it's not so much how many aircraft are based there, but how many return flights we do, how many other locations we connect with Vnukovo. Rather than what we actually had in the past, and the efficiency of the whole network. So there's many different ways you can more or less work on it and get to the right result.
Also, question about the connectivity. What is the influence that Russian passenger traffic gives you, and are you searching for the other opportunities to increase your work or maybe the passenger traffic?
I think we're looking at all possibilities, and we're working with Muzanidis Travel that actually has a base here in Moscow. So again, partnerships are important. Last year we signed a cooperation agreement with Aeroflot as well that enabled us to connect some passengers to our domestic network and vice versa. So obviously there's still a lot to be done because we are small. We need to increase our more or less our route network and then develop that to the next step. So I think the answer is yes, we want to proceed to that front. We're looking at different types and different methods of doing that, always in conjunction with the IT products, inclusive tour products provided by the Muzanidis Group, but also looking at what can be done individually by Elliner to be able to more or less augment what's already been done by them.
And the last questions in general, so are you looking for the other types of aircrafts to lease or to buy? Maybe you're looking on MS-21 or SS?
I think the fleet strategy will be based on the A320 at the moment. So we're actually adding two aircraft, as I said, in. I think the future for the time being will be to increase the fleet with the same type, try and keep it standardized. To be honest, we are talking to a number of parties again on this front, but whatever we do must be more or less standardized. So the same fleet with all our aircraft.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and some questions about the events at all. What's more important information you have here, and what would you change, maybe?
Well, first of all, it's a very well presented event. I think there are a lot of people from different areas here, which is excellent. So it's part of our home market, so it's good for us to be here. I think it's still early days. We've had one quarter of the conference down with excellent presentations and good networking for the time being. So I look forward to the afternoon and the next day as well on top of that.
And what kind of speakers are you waiting next year, maybe? What you are interested in to hear?
Well, on our front, we are interested in what other airlines are doing. So it's important to have other airline customers here as well. It's important to have providers that are innovative, that have something new to show us. We don't want to go through things that we already know or basic information that we already know. It's always good to be presented with something special, something new, and something that we learn out of. And it's not easy because many times you see just a sales pitch, which we don't want. We want to get something out of it, and so far I think we've seen that.
What terms can you advise maybe for the next year? What terms can you advise to?
I think there's ample. I think on the IT side, as mm-hmm. we've already seen, there's going to be year by year a lot of changes. The environment. It's going to be there, it's going to be live. Taxation, how we chase the passenger, and I think we have a discussion on that. How do we get all the parties involved on the same level and on the same more or less wagon to assure that we get the same results? Because everybody's fighting by themselves. The airlines are fighting on one side, the airports are doing something different, but we're not together, and we're not very good in more or less portraying the message that aviation is good. It's good for the economy, it's good for the people, and it's good for more or less developing areas, nations, and so on.